Welcome to another episode of Little Engineers. Today we have our same awesome team, Ishita, Mia, and Pragna. And in case you don't get the name, Ishita, Mia, and Pragna, and we have our resident engineer, Ankur Uncle, and I'm Vishal. Welcome to another episode of Little Engineers. This week we have something exciting to do. So we have been given another repair project, by the way. Do you know? We are going to repair something today.
Do you know why we get the repair project?
We have to open things by ourselves and try to figure out by ourselves.
Yes. So do you know why we got this repair project today?
Because we want the kids to...
Because we fixed the last repair project.
Yeah, remember?
Little Engineers, by the way, did their first successful repair last time. And we'll post the video on the description. And today we got another project to fix. It's exciting. Yes. So let's yes, high five. It's a good. I want to.
No, you got.
You guys are funny. Okay. So now let's start. So what is this?
Light.
This looks exciting. It's a nightlight, by the way. So today we are working on the
nightlight.
Yes.
Mia, did you want to say something?
Yes, Mia.
The nightlight, it's actually not a nightlight. It's just you plug it in, and then when you open the door, it kind of has a scene such a, like, because you, when you open the door, it lights up and lets you go
and
in.
And you know, today we have something sci-fi.
What?
Something very high-tech. Today we're gonna do.
What's a high tech?
This night
really
light.
Have a lot of technology.
This night light uses wireless charging technology.
Oh, so discharges it.
So this thing stays on the electric board, and this guy got charged.
Wow, that guy.
See, this guy is charged with the power, and this guy is getting charged. And do you see any cords in the middle?
Do you have any wires? Do you see any wires?
This is wireless. Yes.
Well, but maybe it's tied this to a wires.
This one is beautiful. This is tied to a wire. But this is the thing that we use as a nightlight. See? This is fascinating. Do you see?
It becomes blue.
Yeah.
And then when we press...
So let's get on. See?
Then
so now, this is what we know. We know this thing has stopped charging. We know this thing still works. So that means the problem is this thing. Because this thing still works.
And that thing doesn't charge anymore.
So what will we do if you want to see how to fix it? We'll open the thing that we need to fix. So Ankur Uncle.
Alright, let's go. Anybody want to take a guess how we open this?
How would you use a flathead to pry it open?
Okay, let's see. Anybody else? You want to see outside underneath that? Mia, do you have any guess?
You can use a flathead to take off these sticky things.
Very good. A flathead screwdriver.
We have some of the best little engineers in the country right here working on this project. So I think we're going to repair this thing today.
So we go for our suggestion and use a flathead screwdriver.
Mia, good job. You figured it out.
Good job.
You guys did a good job.
Both of you did.
It's a team that matters, right?
Yeah, your team, the team
little engineers. I'm cutting it to see if it comes out with a nail or with this.
Yeah.
Yes.
And you guys are a team, so your team figured it out.
And I knew because
I've heard this. Alright, first we'll take the screws out
so we'll see.
We don't lose them, okay?
So
here we go, four screws. We'll put them in the magnetic tray.
Don't even make noise.
I know. But these guys are not... Anyways, yes. Okay.
Maybe there's a wire stuck in it. Oh,
yeah,
there is a wire.
Okay.
Alright. Okay, I see a circuit board.
Nice. Yes.
Very good. Okay, now let's try to see what are the main components, okay? So, this is a circuit board, as Pragna pointed out.
I see north and south.
Yeah. And anybody wants to get what these are?
Yeah.
What are those?
I don't know what those are, but
No. Probably wrong, yes?
Yeah. Is it a north and south pole?
I'll give you a hint. It's the same thing as this. Do you guys know what this is?
Yeah, I know.
What is it?
The thing that holds it and then lets it go.
Yes.
What is it called?
A battery?
No, no. Very close.
I forgot.
It's called a capacitor.
Because it has a capacity.
So this charge. Yeah, this so this one is also a capacitor. It holds the charge.
Does it go like this? What does a capacitor do?
That's a very good question. Yeah, that's a very good question. Okay. So the capacitor when we
charge, then let's go to another capacitor or straight to the circuit.
Yeah. Yes. So the capacitor, think of it as like a water tank. So electricity is coming in like a water, like a pipe. It wants to go fast. The capacitor is like a water tank. When it holds the water, so it doesn't flow all the time, so you can have the capacitor hold the water and then let it go slowly by slowly, right? You know how when you get water from the tap, right, and it's coming fast, you put it in a jug first, right, before you put it in a glass, right? Because if you try to just put it in the glass like that, it'll spill, right? Mm-hmm. So what you do is you put it in a jug and then jug holds the water, right, and then you can slowly pour out of it. Same thing capacitor does. It holds the charge, it acts like a jug, and then you can slowly get the charge out of it. You understand?
It holds the battery and then when the light is on, then it just brings the battery to so it can put the light?
Yeah. So now anybody wants to guess what these little things are? The white ones?
Yeah. I know.
What are they called? There's an R right next to them, if you can see that.
Ow, I know.
What is it?
What have you heard? It starts with R.
I know what they are.
Okay,
Wait, keep it on the bench.
The subject.
Little engineers, today we'll learn something interesting now. So, whenever we're working on something that we're either repairing or we're working on, engineers, so that thing will never leave the workbench. Okay? Yeah. Because workbench is meant for our safety. So we will never take things and put it on R because then we might get hurt.
Okay.
We can die.
Alright, so...
Oh, we can make it. It's boo-boo. It depends. Yeah.
Alright, so guys, what are these white little things? They start with R. Anybody wants to make a guess? Further?
Is it called resistor?
Oh, yes. Very good.
The best little engineers in the whole country.
I forget about that. That's good. You guys are a team.
So what does it do here?
You guys are a team.
I didn't even hear the name of a resistor. I talked of a name like resistor.
So that's why I said resistor.
I think that's a fascinating.
So anybody wants to make a guess what resistor
is?
Okay.
A resistor is something that holds the electricity, mm-hmm. and it connects to this. It connects to the circuit board, mm-hmm. and the circuit board kind of connects to the. It just. Connects.
What does it do though? What's its role? You know how the capacitor role is to hold the water, like the charge. What is the resistor's role?
Oh, the resistor's role is to
Anybody remembers or want to make a guess? I'll tell you. The resistor's role is to slow electricity down. Remember, I will always tell you that in Klein example, if the surface is flat, water will go fast. But if you go make it like this, it'll go slow up the elevation. So the resistor's role is to slow electricity down. It says, okay, electricity, you slow down, you're going too fast. Can you please slow down?
So I have one more point to point here. So do you know what is the most advanced technology that we all have that is helping us figure things out? It's called eyes. Do you know that? Okay. We can look at things and we can see if something is going wrong or not. Now we know the circuit is bad. Right?
Let's get to the base parts.
Right.
Then we have to talk about diagnostics. That we shall.
Yes, that's a good point. Yes.
Circuit board is burned, maybe.
Yeah, we'll make the guesses in a few minutes.
Exactly.
Let's figure out the base parts, right? So, because if we have to figure out something is broken, Okay, that's okay. Yeah, I'll bring it to you. Okay.
Maybe you guys can share. Maybe you can come slightly on this side. That's fine.
Yeah. Just join it with Ishida's share.
Yes.
All right. That's
Be very careful.
Very careful. All right. Now, no moving. Okay. So now you guys have to pay attention. In order to figure out what's wrong, first let's understand the base parts of this mechanism, right? So we have electricity coming in here with the wires. It is going to the circuit board. So we know the circuit board. We know the capacitors. We talked about them, right? And we talked about the resistors, these white ones. Anybody knows what these black ones are?
Oh, no, I know.
What are they called?
But they're kind of like resistors, but they do something else.
Yeah, they are called diodes. So these
maybe they make it go fast.
Yeah, so what diodes do is they let electricity, they are like a gate. They can only let electricity go in one side and they don't let the electricity go on the other side. It's like a one-way street, right? So it makes the electricity follow a certain direction because electricity go like this way, but it can go the other way. So it stops, says electricity, you can only go this way. That way, electricity goes in a systematic manner everywhere. Okay? So these are called, what are they called?
Yeah, like pretty much.
What are they called again?
Diodes.
And just like when you see a gate, the gate only leads you to one way.
Yes. What is it called again here?
It's a diode.
Diode. Okay, now let's come to what Uncle Shah was saying. So he was saying, in order to figure something, if something is wrong, we can use our eyes. Do you guys see something which is obviously wrong?
No, I think that's a good point though. But I think let's talk about the magical thing on that. I think you brought up an interesting point.
Mm-hmm.
Let's understand the circuitry and the functioning first.
Yep.
So if you want to see how things, what's broken, first we have to figure out how things work.
Good point.
Thank you, Pradna. So now, let's see how the I want to know that too.
Well, let's figure out how it works.
Wireless charging works.
Okay, perfect.
Yes.
So
maybe it's a bluff.
Yeah, that's a very good hint. We'll use it later, okay?
Maybe it's making dust and it's making the finger.
Yeah, we'll figure it out.
That's a very good hint.
So now let's figure it out how it works. So look, this is bringing the electricity in. You see the two wires coming in?
Yeah.
They're bringing the electricity in. Then what we're doing is, there's this, does anybody know what this is?
A transformer? Transformer.
It's not a transformer really, but it's like an electric, Mia, stay back please. It's a mechanism that's converting the electricity like a transformer. It's called an integrated circuit. There's a smart circuit in there which converts the
electricity. What's a smart circuit?
So it's a circuit that changes its shape based on what electricity is doing, okay? So,
Can I take a look at this?
People call them ICs or integrated circuits. Okay, so they perform a function which is already assigned to them. Okay, so in this case, you know what function they are performing?
You know the problem, no?
They are converting electricity from when it's coming in, and they're telling electricity to do something very special. You know what it's doing? It's telling electricity to do.
It's going to make the light.
Create a magnet. So this remember Uncle Vishal was saying that this thing is based on what we call a induction wireless charging. And the way it achieves wireless charging is through this big magnet right here, and it's called the induction charging magnet.
I have a hunch.
Mm-hmm.
Is this thing a relay by any chance? I think this.
Yeah, there's a coil inside it.
Isn't this guy a relay?
This could be, let's see.
I think this is a relay.
This could be a relay, you're right.
Because I think we'll discuss that. It helps the unidirectional.
So it could, what Uncle Vishal is saying is this is a special kind of integrated circuit which helps to change charge direction as the electric current comes in. It probably is a too advanced topic for right now, but it helps the charge, the electric current change directions. But the main component is in this whole thing is this big thing. This is called an induction charger. And do you know how it works?
No.
Alright, let me try to explain how it works, okay? So we all remember from our previous videos that I'll draw something and you have to tell me what this is, okay? What's a north and south?
What is that?
There are two magnets.
Two poles of the magnet.
Which do not repel each other.
Yes. So, and you all remember how we can create a north south magnet by just not having actually a magnet? We can pass electricity and create a magnet, right?
Yeah.
Electricity can create a magnet. Now,
do the positive and negative.
Yes. So, what this thing is, this big circle you see, think of it as like a big ball. So, if this was south, Ishita, you remember, what does south attract?
It attracts north and north.
Yes. So what if this is south, it makes this ball, this big charging ball, create a north and south pole.
This is this side and this is this side.
Right? And now what happens is imagine if the north side was all negative electrons, and imagine if this was positive charge. Okay? Positrons sometimes called. So what happens is, when the south comes in, it brings all these ones close to, so this becomes a negative charge and this becomes a positive charge. And if we separate these two, now we have a positive charge and a negative charge, and that's what a battery is. A battery, if you see a battery, if you see the battery that you guys are used to seeing, remember it says like positive on one side and says negative on one side, remember?
Yeah, that's on my... Snap circuit
alarm. Yeah.
So see, it says
like
shout out to Snap Circuits.
So think of this.
When this positive and negative happen, this becomes like a battery.
Battery, yeah.
So it just created a little battery inside the circuit.
So see what's happening? So this guy acted as this magnet, and this thing is just staying here. I say, I don't know, I'm losing charge, I can't do anything more. The moment you bring these guys together, this will start bringing all the negatives together and south here. And then this guy will become a battery-powered Nightlite!
Yes!
Good point!
Alright.
Good point!
Alright, come on guys.
It's exciting!
It's too exciting!
So
now we know how it works. So we know that the electric charge was coming in. The circuit was helping the electric charge go in a certain way, so to create a positive magnet here, right? And then the magnet was supposed to charge the light, right? By creating the battery, by separating the positive and the negative charge, right? Now, we've done that, but now you have to figure out something is broken. Now, I'll go back to what Ishita had pointed out.
That's a very good observation.
Ishita had a good observation.
So now we are playing like a detectives.
Yes.
Like it was like dust and like it was coming onto it. Yeah. So it
was
making
So now.
Good point, Ishita.
So now let's see. Let's see how.
So Mia, this was a black smudge. You just touched your finger and saw that, right? Mm. So if this is black, that means, what do you think happened?
It must have got like spoiled with a black thing and touching the circuit.
Yeah, maybe something got burned.
Burned, yeah. That's one of the most common reason of why circuits. And this is one of the most common reason of why circuit fails.
Yeah.
Right?
So now, do you guys see something burned here? Is there any sign of something burning here?
Do you see?
I'll give it to everyone.
So now you can see if anything you see here that has a any color that you don't.
We are not taking it away. Remember?
Yes. So okay, do you see anything that's out of ordinary? Girls, you all three, take a very close look on this and see if anything that looks different to you.
Maybe be very close.
Yeah. Yes, Pratna.
Maybe this.
Keep on looking.
Mushy.
But there's no.
One way of telling if something is broken or not is to compare things. So if you compare this and this, does it look the same?
No. One has down
the same.
Silver and this.
But they look the same, right?
Do they look burnt? Doesn't look the same.
Maybe they have to be the same.
Yeah. What about the resistors? If you look at the resistors, do all resistors look the same?
No.
Which one looks different?
This one.
Yeah.
Maybe that
and if you look at this, Now it's right above this cutting resistor, right?
Right.
So if, what if this got burned and it's left all the smudges here?
So that's exactly what happened. This is great, Ishita.
Good point, Papa.
So look.
Mia.
Actually, I want to point it out there.
Yes, that's good. So Ishita, so that's you found it. So look.
So Ishita found the problem in our circuit. So we know what's going on.
So
we think we know what's going on.
That was not supposed to be there.
So you know what the normal, let's figure out what a normal resistor looks like.
Maybe we can smoke in it and then it just wasn't bad.
Yes.
Wow. Good point, Ishita.
Wow.
So you know what happens? Ishita and Mia and Pari. So pay attention. What does the resistance do? Remember, if anybody remember from previous, what was the resistance role? What was it doing? What? Okay.
It slows down the electricity.
Yeah. Okay. That, do you remember that, Mia?
It was my turn.
That's okay. Yeah. Do you remember that? What's the resistance role?
It slows down the electricity.
Yeah. So you know what? Well, sometimes when me, you want to say something?
What is this?
That's a relay. We'll come back to it, or integrator. We'll come back to that. But we were talking about the resistor first, okay? So the resistor's role is to say electricity slow down, right? And sometimes electricity doesn't listen to the resistor and it gets burned, right? So the resistor gets burned. So the way a normal resistor is supposed to look like, it's supposed to look like this white.
Very clean.
But it also has these bands on it. You see like the blue and the white and the golden band on the resistor? Yeah.
But look at all the bands.
Maybe that's a design.
No, yes.
Maybe it's to hold it all to the circuit board.
Yes, very good. So what you know what the two ends are holding it down. So if you see those two little metal ends.
If you look in the middle, then you look at bands, like circular bands of different colors.
Almost like rubber bands.
Yes, exactly.
Yes. Yeah. So you know why these bands are there for? These bands are to tell us. No, that's a good guess, honey. But these bands are to tell that what kind of resistor is this. So we will show this in a separate video. But these bands help us. You know how sometimes when you look at the battery, it says 20 volt and all that stuff. But by reading these bands, you can figure out how many voltage is this, or how much resistance this resistor actually produces.
It's a code word.
It's a code.
It's a code word that it's telling, so we can, because it's a very tiny resistor, right? So we can't, if we write something, we can't read it through our eyes, right? We need to use a magnifying glass. So to make it reading simple, they just put these circular bands.
Yeah. So
good point.
Yes.
Good point. Maybe they're tiny words on the band. Good point, Mia.
Wow, that's a maybe something of the future.
Yeah.
So maybe we should use the band to tell something. So we should write something on the band. Yeah, I think.
Alright, so now let's get back to this, okay? So these bands are okay, these bands are okay. So now we know these bands, and even though this is resistance burned, we can figure out which resistor to buy. We need to say, okay, we need to have a resistor that looks like this and this and this in the band, and we can go find a resistor that matches this and replace this, and then hopefully the light will work. We'll have to test it, right?
Yeah! Good idea!
That was good detector. Now,
good.
And by the way, Ishita cracked this code for us. I think this detective job is...
Ishita,
so your team did a fabulous job. And Ishita, you actually helped us figure it out.
Yeah, and that was good work on my little engineers team. Everybody contributed.
So now we found out our culprit. That's the resistance. And Uncle, mm-hmm. Anything else we need to cover here?
Okay, I want to cover one last item. So guys, before we close this down, I want to just go around and see... After we've talked around, I'll describe it once myself first. It's a magnet trying to pull it together. So I'll describe it once, but then I want you guys to describe how the light works. Okay? So the way this light, induction light works is electricity comes in from the wires, then it goes into the circuit board first, and then based on the relay or the integrated circuit and these components, which are resistors, diodes, and capacitors, it follows a certain path to go to the induction magnet. And then induction magnet produces electricity based on the concept we talked about, right? By separating the positive and the negative charges by using magnet, right?
Yeah.
This is how, and then you can use that to charge the
magnet.
To the light. So yes. Now I'm going to ask you guys and see if you guys can explain this, okay?
Well, if it was locked, then...
Okay.
The wires go into the circuit board.
Okay.
And then it comes into the...
Yeah, your turn will come.
I know the something. Resistor.
No, mine is
and then go into the...
Mm-hmm.
What's this
it's
called?
I forgot.
Okay, induction magnet. It has induction coil in it. You see there's a coil, right? You see those?
No,
it
goes into the
coil and then it goes to the north, negative, and then the positive then it comes to the resistor.
Yeah, alright, Mia, you want to take a guess as well?
So, the electricity comes in from here, it goes into the circuit board,
mm-hmm.
and ends up over here.
Mm-hmm.
And then we didn't talk about this.
Okay.
It's a color tube.
Mm-hmm.
So let's go to here. Maybe.
Okay.
So it goes here, mm-hmm. and then there's a certain path
mm-hmm.
that then it goes here,
mm-hmm.
and then there's a certain path that leads it to this.
Yeah. So how does it follow that path? Is there anything that on the circuit board that helps you to follow the path?
It needs to. Stop.
Okay. Hold on.
No, it's my turn.
Okay.
So these...
What are those things called?
They're capacitors and these things.
Diode
things.
Uh-huh.
And the... Oh yeah, I talked...
Capacitor.
Uh-huh. And then they just make a way for it to come here.
What is this?
IE...
Induction coil. You see there's a coil in there? You see the little copper coil in there?
Yeah.
You see that, Mia?
Yeah.
If you look here, you see little copper, golden copper coil.
Wait, can I see it?
Look.
Be careful. I think we got another casualty.
Please,
so we have to be. I think that's why we don't. Engineers. So we have a lesson here.
Uh-huh.
Since we were taking this thing away from the bench, we just broke this. So we have to again fix this too. That's why we don't move things from the bench because then we can keep it protected.
Okay.
So we have to also fix this wire, which is easy by the way, we can do that.
Yeah.
But just a lesson that on the workbench, never take things away from the workbench.
Yeah.
It keeps circuits safe, it keeps us safe.
Okay.
We can do it soldering.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, yeah, we have to do it by soldering. Yes, that's a good point. But now we have to do that soldering, right? Otherwise, if it wasn't broken, we wouldn't have to do the soldering. All right, so now, Ishita, you want to describe it quickly without moving it?
So the electricity goes to the wires, then it goes to the circuit board, then it...
Mia, stay in there. Stay as a team. You should listen to what your team member is saying.
That...
Okay. Stay back.
What are these again?
Uh-huh.
What are these again?
These are resistors.
So it... Of the resistors, the diodes and the capacitors, they make a path to the
induction coil,
and then
how does the induction coil charge the battery by separating?
The positive charges and the negative charges.
Very good. So that was the description. So now we'll go ahead.
Can I get a tissue to wipe the black stuff?
Yes. We'll do it later.
I think we will do it. That's a very so again, engineers, good job there. We have to clean the circuit and we'll do everything, put it back how it should be. So this concludes the video
of the diagnostic portion.
And so we were able to figure out thanks to our little engineer team and Ishita, you guys did a good job. And now we'll fix those things and we'll post it on the comments. If that ended up fixing the problem. And that being said, we have a lot of hands raised. Yes.
And if you find a battery, we'll just send it to us, okay?
That's interesting. Maybe yes. So send us in the on the comments if something is broken. Maybe we can our little engineers team could help and put up a video of how to fix that. I think that's a good point. Yes, Mia. We can talk. Yes.
You can.
Pragna's call. Yes, Pragna.
And subscribe to our videos.
I think that is the most important part. So if you are eating something, put the thing down. If you are drinking something, it can wait. But to support our little engineers who have now fixed the second item. Isn't how cool is that? Subscribe, support this team, support us so we can put up more videos. And thank you so much, and thanks to team. Amazing people. You guys like it?